Well, the baby's monkey, he's got the three monkey.
There ain't no bugs on me. There ain't no bugs on me. There may be bugs on me.
That's lights down.
House rent's going down. Now you can come on. Hold on. Yes. 20 seconds. Everybody on stage.
And the line the back comes to play. The best bus comes to play. Any old time, but it doesn't come to stay.
But there ain't no bugs on me. There ain't no bugs on me. There may be bugs on some of your mouth, but there ain't no bugs on me.
Lights are up.
Lights up.
Okay, go on, so Howard, tell them what else Mr. King's told you in the class.
Well, at first he said the earth was too hot for any life. Then it cooled off a lot. And sails began to live.
Sails?
Little bugs like in the water. Then the little bugs got bigger bugs and spider legs and crawled up on the land.
And how long did all this take, according to Mr. Case?
A couple million years, maybe longer. Mm-hmm. Then comes the fishes and the reptiles and the mammals. Man's mammals.
Along with the dogs and the cattle in the fields, did he say that?
Yes, sir.
Now, Howard. How did man come out of all this slimy mess of bugs and serpents, according to your professor?
Man was sort of evoluted from the old world monkeys.
Ha! Did you hear that, my friends? Old world monkeys! According to Mr. Cates, you and I aren't even descended from good American monkeys! Now listen carefully, Howard. In all this talk of bugs and the evolution of slime and ooze, did Mr. Cates ever make any reference to God?
Not as I remember.
Or to the miracle he achieved within 7 days, as described in the beautiful book of Genesis?
No, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen!
Objection! I'd like the court to remind the counsel for the prosecution that he is supposed to be submitting evidence to a jury. Am I blowing that line? Should talk about that? Yeah. I'd like the court to remind the learned counsel of the prosecution that he's not in a Chautauqua tent. He's supposed to be submitting evidence to a jury. There are no ladies in the jury.
Your Honor, I have no intention of making a speech. There is no need. I am sure that everyone on the jury, everyone within the sound of this boy's voice, will be moved by his tragic confusion. He has been taught that he wriggled up like an animal from the depths and the filth below. I say that these Bible haters, these evolutionists, are brewers of poison.
Amen.
Amen.
And the state, and this the legislature of this sovereign state has had the good fortune, has had the good wisdom to demand that the peddlers of poison, be it in bottles or in books, clearly label the products they attempt to sell.
Yes. Amen.
I tell you that if this law is not upheld, then this boy will become one of a generation shorn of its faith by the teachings of godless science. Oh. But if the full penalty of the law is meted out to Bertram Cates, then the faithful the world over who are watching us now and listening to our every word will call this courtroom blessed.
Yo,
from a book.
Is this the book? Darwin's theory on the evolution and the descent of man?
Yes, sir.
That's right, Howard. This is the book that he read to you in your classroom. Now, Howard, do you think there's anything wrong about that?
Well, I don't know.
Objection, Your Honor! The defense is asking a 13-year-old boy hand down an opinion on a question of morality.
Yeah, well.
I'm just trying to establish, Your Honor, that Howard or Mr. Brady or anybody else in this courtroom or you yourself, sir, have the right to think.
Well, the right to think is not on trial here.
With all due respect to the bench, sir, I hold that the right to think is very much on trial here. It is in fearful danger in the proceedings of this court.
A man is on trial.
A thinking man who faces fines and imprisonment because he chooses to speak what he thinks.
Colonel Drum, would you please rephrase the question?
All right, let me put it this way, Howard. All this fuss and feathers about evolution hasn't hurt you at all?
Sir?
Well, has it done you any harm? You still feel reasonably fit? Do you still feel reasonably fit? The things that Mr. Cates told you, did it hurt your baseball game at all? You know, affect your pitching arm?
No, sir. I'm a lefty.
Oh, southpaw. line.
Still on your...
Oh, yeah. A southpaw. Still on your mother and your father?
Sure.
You haven't murdered anybody since breakfast.
Objection!
Objection sustained.
Ask him if his faith in the Holy Scriptures has been shattered.
When I need your valuable assistance, Colonel, I shall humbly ask for it. Mm. Now, Colonel, Howard, whatever you are, my lovely sergeant.
You will leave us.
Now, Howard, I'll get it. Now, Howard, do you believe everything that Mr. Cates told you?
I don't know. I gotta think it over.
Good for you. Your pa's a farmer, isn't he?
Yes, sir.
Got a tractor?
Brand new one.
Howard, you think it's sinful? You think a tractor's sinful because it's not mentioned in the Bible?
I don't know.
Moses never made a phone call. Do you think that makes the telephone an instrument of the devil?
Never thought of it that
way. Neither did anyone else. Your Honor. The defense makes the same old error of all godless men. They confuse material things with the great spiritual reality of the revealed word. Why do you bewilder this boy? Yeah. Does right have no meaning to you, sir? Yeah.
Realizing I may bridge the case of my client, I must say that right has no meaning for me whatsoever. Truth has meaning. As a direction. It's one of the peculiar imbecilities of our time that we've placed this grid of right and wrong, this grid of morality over all human behavior so that every act of man is measured against a latitude of right and a longitude of wrong in exact seconds, minutes, and degrees. You have any idea what I'm talking about, Howard?
No, sir.
Well, maybe you will someday. That's all for now, son. Thanks.
I've seen what you can do to a jury. Twist and tangle them. Nobody's forgotten.